Yeah, hello and welcome to Cimbrer Bushcraft. Today I'm in my Black Forest in this shelter where Martin and I made an overnighter some month ago. Last in this video I'll put a link to that video so you can see how it looks when it's summer out here. Yeah, but there's still a lot of snow here in the northern part of Denmark, and it's really cozy to look out, sit here in the shelter, nice and warm and cozy, and to look out on this landscape. Yeah, I'm going to make a big fire in front of the shelter, and I can see someone has made a sawhorse so I can saw my wood there, but first I have to cut a tree, and I found a dead standing spruce down in the forest, and I think I'll cut that down and use that for firewood. Yeah, so first a little bit of work, then I have my food out here. I prepared a little stew that I will tell you about when I'm going to do that. So, and you saw my little lantern. Yeah, isn't it nice and cozy? And I put a link for this video where I have show how you can make such a lantern, so you can find out if that's something for you. It's very easy actually. Yeah, but it's a cold day, a gray day, very dark day. There's not many days when the shortest day in the year is coming. Solhverv, as we call it, winter solstice, I think it's called in English. Yeah, so that's the shortest day in the northern part of the world. Yeah, but now I think we're going to cut a little tree and chop up some firewood and make that fire. Yeah.
And this is sawdust with fatwood shaving in. It's the first time I try this, but I hope it will work. Yeah, and this is a fire anchor from TJM Metalworks. Most of you have seen that before. I made a customization of it, and I'll tell you why. I bought the small one, the small fire anchor, and it's really awesome, but it's a little bit too small for my Caldrone. So this one, my original, the big one, the fire anchor, I will use that instead. It's very sturdy and can hold a lot of kilos. But I made this pan, and of course I made it when I thought I should use the little one. Just a moment. So this piece of iron is a little bit smaller than the big one, so I just made an adapter. See this? A little, can you see that? A little tube. I put on this and then it fits. You can see this has a little, yeah, angle, so it fits in here. Yeah. So this is going to be used today for making my flatbreads. Yeah. It's going to be a very simple meal, like the Vikings would have made it. Spring onions, always good. And of course some meats, some smoked pork, also known as bacon. Oh yeah. So this is in ingredients, but beside that I have some dried mushrooms here. There's a mushroom I picked up in the fall and dried them in my oven. So I'm going to put that in too. First, put a little oil in. Not much. And then the bacon. Oh yeah. Very windy today, you can see. And then I put the onion and carrots in. And a little bit of water. Yeah. And finally, some dried mushrooms. Yep. And let it cook at least half an hour, I think. Yeah, and while the stew is cooking, I'm going to make some dough for a little bit of flatbread. First flour. You can use many kinds of flour for this. I put a little dry yeast in, and some salt, some honey. Yep, a little bit of oil, and of course some water. Then I just have to mix it. Let it rest for a while under this. Yeah. Let's see if the stew is boiling. Oh yeah.
I think it's enough. And I'll make it flat. Yeah, almost like a heart, a Christmas heart. Yeah.
I'll take this one off. Put this one over.
Now it's beginning to, actually rain. So I'm glad I'm almost finished with my cooking. Getting there.
Now the bread is almost finished, and I would very much like to have my coffee after my meal, so I'll put this one over. Let's see how I do it. Oh yeah. My little stew. Seems that it's a success. Yeah.
Look at this. Over here. Yeah. A nice pork stew. Yeah, looks very delicious. Mmm.
Mustn't forget. I bought a Christmas beer. Yep. Oh yeah. Good everyone. Mmm. Right. Nice and strong. Yeah, it's 6% alcohol. Just my kind of beer. a little bit of salt in to remove the bitterness. And then the lid on. Almost boiling. Yeah, now it's boiling. The weather is changing between rain and snow.
Yeah, folks, this is all for now. I hope you enjoyed this little video from this Viking shelter in the Black Forest. It was a delicious meal. It was actually better than I had thought of, because it was very tasty and the bacon makes a good gravy. It's really good. So, yeah. It's almost 3 o'clock now and it's getting dark very soon. So I have to pack my gear and heading home. I have an hour drive here from until I'm home in the city I live in. So, yeah. But I'm glad you joined me again. And then I hope to see you again on the next one. Bye bye. Take care.